In this Black Mirror Season 5 episode breakdown, we're gonna be talking about the episode Striking Vipers. And there's actually quite a bit that we can learn from this episode, so make sure that you stay tuned. What is up, everybody? This is Chris from The Rewired Soul, where we talk about the problem, but focus on the solution. And if you're new to my channel, what I like to do is take a look at movies, TV shows, the YouTube community, what's going on in pop culture, try to see what lessons we can learn from them. So if you're into that stuff, make sure you subscribe and ring that notification bell. And especially subscribe if you are a fan of Black Mirror, like myself, because I'm binging season 5 right now, and I have a few videos planned to break down different episodes. I just posted my last video breaking down the episode Rachel, Jack, and Ashley 2. So this one we're talking about Striking Vipers, and then I will be talking about the other episode. So anyways, let's do a quick little episode breakdown, go over the synopsis, what happened and everything, and then we'll talk about the ending of this episode, all right? So the episode starts off where Danny and Carl, they are best friends and they are roommates, and they were younger, and Theo is living with them as well, and they played a video game called Striking Vipers. Striking Vipers seems kind of like Street Fighter, all right? But anyways, 11 years pass, and it seems like Danny and Carl are not as close as they used to be. Carl shows up to Danny's birthday party, and Danny is kind of like checking out of the women, so I'm like, okay, that's kind of interesting. But anyways, Carl ended up buying Danny the brand new Striking Vipers video game, where it has like this VR hookup, but in typical Black Mirror fashion, it's like the thing that you put on the side of your head, and your eyes turn all white, and then boom, you are inside or doing something that involves a computer, okay? So what ends up happening is they go into the game and yeah, they end up becoming very sexually attracted to each other and they hook up. So while Danny has been checking out other women, you can see that Carl, in his relationships, he hasn't been as into, you know, anybody that he's dated. So Danny and Carl, they start going into this video game on a regular basis and hooking up. So Theo, she starts realizing that Danny is kind of pulling away. They're trying to conceive another baby, but Danny is always tired, all right? So we see it going on, and finally, on their anniversary, Danny and Theo go out, and Theo was hit on at the bar by a man, and she goes and talks to Danny when they finally sit down for dinner, and she's like, yo, dude, like, you forgot about our anniversary, you haven't been physically attracted to me, you seem like you're spacing out, what's going on? Are you cheating on me? And Danny's like, no. And I found this kind of interesting because, like, not to give anybody advice on how to lie in this situation, but I'm like, Danny, why don't you just tell her that you're always home? That'll help the situation. But anyways, he continues to lie to her about not cheating on her. And it's kind of a weird situation. Like, is it technically cheating? That was kind of Carl's argument, which we'll touch on in a second. But anyways, one of the key points that led to the ending of this episode was that Theo was talking about how she's made sacrifices for this relationship too. She's made sacrifices for this family because they have a child together, and she was just hit on by a guy at the bar. That is the point where he's like, yo, Carl, we gotta knock this off. Sorry, dude, whatever. And they stop talking. Fast forward 7 months, Theo is now pregnant. We see Carl kind of freaking out in his apartment. He misses this thing, right? That him and Danny had inside of this video game. So the following year, on Danny's birthday, Theo decides to surprise Danny by inviting Carl over. And when they're at the table by themselves, while Theo is over getting dessert for them, Carl is like, yo man, like, I miss it, let's do this thing, midnight, let's log back in, you know, and Danny's conflicted about it, but then he ends up doing it anyways. So they do it and he's like, what is this? Like, he's not sure if he's gay or if it's just this video game, because Carl is taking on the avatar of a woman in this video game. So they end up meeting up and they want to kiss to see, like, is this a real thing? Are they actually attracted to each other, or is it just part of this virtual reality video game? So they end up kissing, no sparks are there. Then they get into a little fight, which turns physical, and they both get arrested. So Theo, she knew something was up at dinner, but she goes to pick him up, and the end of the episode kind of ends with, like, Theo being like, yo, Danny, what's going on, right? Why are you guys fighting? What is happening? And basically, in the end credits, we see what happened. So it looks like it's the following year on Danny's birthday, and Theo ends up giving Danny something. He's like, I want this back, right? And they swap. So what ends up happening, it looks like they made some kind of compromise where Danny can go into the video game, sleep with his best friend inside of this video game, and Theo gets to go out and actually hook up with somebody else. All right, so that is the compromise they made. So what does this have to do with real life? All right, this is something that I've touched on in previous videos, talking about different YouTubers, talking about relationships, talking about trying to cling on to relationships when it's just not working. All right, so what we see is Danny and Theo are trying to make this relationship work. They've been together forever. They've been together for what, over 10 years at least. And now they have a family together. Now they have two kids together by the end of this episode. So they're trying to stay together now, not only for their relationship, but seems like for the kids as well. So they're making a compromise where Danny can still sleep with Carl inside of a video game and Theo is out sleeping with somebody in real life. But like, is this the solution? Is it worth it to go out and have an open relationship of some sort in order to save a relationship? Now, I'm gonna talk about this in two different scenarios. There's one where you have kids and there's one where you don't have kids. So when you don't have kids, like, I will say this and like, just based on the statistics of what I've seen in my personal life and all of my friends and seeing things happen, you know, in the public spotlight, like, just let go of the relationship. Like, if there's no kids involved, like, let go of the relationship. Quit trying to hold on to it because it gets messy. It gets messy, like, especially if you're married, right? Like, you are making a commitment to that person. Like, you are the only person for me. That is it, right? And when those feelings start to disappear, like, that's the reason why they have divorces and all of that. But the thing is that no matter what people say, for most people who have been brought up, you know, being taught monogamy, like, I have nothing against open relationships, polyamory, or anything like that. The issue that I find is people are wired, especially in the Western culture, for monogamy. So when they try doing this open relationship or they try experiencing polyamory, things go real bad real quick because emotions start to get developed. Like, there are many successful open relationships and polyamorous relationships, but the thing is, when you're doing it, from my experience, when you're doing it to try to save a relationship, that's typically when it all falls apart, right? So obviously we didn't see what happened later in this episode of Striking Vipers, right? But like, would this continue to be something cool as years go by? Is this something that actually keeps the relationship? Or does it cause more fights? Or do they keep growing distant from each other because that spark is not there anymore? Now, the question is, what if you're in a relationship and there's children involved? So those of you who don't know me, I am a father. I also have my beautiful girlfriend, Tristan. So my son, he is with my ex and we split custody of him, all right? So he's with her, you know, for a few days a week, he's with me a few days a week and all that, and we have an amazing relationship together, and I'm a very fortunate person. If any of you want to check it out, I made a video on Mother's Day about how fortunate I am to have my son's mother as his mother and in my life. But anyway, something that I learned at a younger age after my son was born and we were trying to make this relationship work, like, we were trying to hold on to this relationship and make it work for him. And I don't know about any of you, but I come from a divorced household, right? But when my parents were together when I was a kid, like, there was nonstop fighting. And that kind of stuff was more damaging to me as a child than when they actually split up. So my son's mother and I, we kind of realized that as well, and we ended up splitting up. Now, any of you who really know me, you know I'm a recovering drug addict and alcoholic, so don't get me wrong. That also played a major role in this. But what I'm getting at is, when we split up and we put our son first, and wanted to make sure, you know, we provided the best life for him possible, and not just like making sure he has a roof over his head and toys or, you know, food or whatever that is. We wanted to make sure that his parents had a good relationship, like, because we knew how it would affect him if her and I were still fighting back and forth. And now my son, like, I don't know, I wish I can compare my son to other kids who come from, you know, quote unquote, broken households, because my son is thriving and doing excellent, right? He is emotionally stable. He is doing great in school and all that. So the point I'm getting at is, there's this idea that you have to stay together for the kids, but in reality, if both parents are able to just, I don't know, be adults and not try to like use their child as a weapon, going back and forth and things like that, you can split up and co-parent in a healthy way, all right? Because when I look at this situation from Black Mirror in Striking Vipers, like, how long is this gonna go on for, right? What happens when the kids get older? Are they gonna ask questions? How is this gonna make sense to them? And all of that stuff, you know? Is this healthier for them to do this and sleep with other people, even though Danny was sleeping with Carl virtually? Like, is that healthier than them splitting up and just co-parenting in a healthy way? Personally, I don't think so, but I would love to know your thoughts on this topic down in the comments below, and let me know what you thought about this episode and the other episodes, all right? If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up. If you're new, make sure you subscribe and ring that notification bell, because like I said, I am breaking down each episode of Black Mirror, and I might do a couple videos for some of these episodes. So anyways, make sure you're subscribed with the notifications turned on. And a huge, huge thank you to everybody who is out there supporting the channel over on Patreon. You are all amazing. And if you would like to support what I'm doing here by becoming a patron, get your name up in the credits, get access to our monthly Q&A and some other perks and benefits like the books I wrote, click or tap on that Patreon icon right there, all right? Thanks again so, so much for watching. I'll see you next time.